We want to evaluate the definite integral, which requires the method of substitution. When using the method of substitution, we let part of the integrand function be equal to u, so the derivative of u resembles the remaining part of the integrand function. It's important to know the basic derivative formulas to use the method of substitution. In this case, recall the derivative of inverse cosine x equals negative 1 divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared. So because the derivative of u resembles the remaining part of the integrand function, we begin by letting u equal inverse cosine x. Next, we determine differential u, where differential u is equal to negative 1 divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared dx. Before we compare u and du to the given integral, let's factor out the 2 and write this as 2 times integral from 0 to 1 half of inverse cosine x divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared dx. So we know u is equal to inverse cosine x, and du is equal to negative 1 divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared dx. Notice our integrand function doesn't have a negative, so let's multiply both sides by negative 1 and write this equation as negative du equals 1 divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared dx. If we want to, we can include a factor of 1 in the numerator. To make it easier to recognize, we can now substitute negative du for 1 divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared dx. Now we write the integral with respect to u, but we need to be careful. The limits of integration of 0 and 1 half are x values, not u values, and therefore we'll leave the limits off for now. With respect to u, we have 2 times the integral of, again, 1 divided by the square root of the quantity 1 minus x squared dx equals negative du. Let's factor out the negative, and then we have du. And inverse cosine x is equal to u. Notice now we have a much simpler integral, and we need to make a choice. We can quickly find the antiderivative with respect to u, write it back in terms of x, and then use the original limits of integration, or we can leave it in terms of u, but we'll have to find new limits of integration. For this example, let's determine new limits of integration with respect to u. To begin, we need to determine u when x equals 0. To do this, we'll use the equation u equals inverse cosine x. So when x is 0, notice u equals inverse cosine of 0, which you should recognize is equal to pi divided by 2, which is the lower limit of integration. Just to review how I got pi over 2, we can use a unit circle. We're looking for the angle that has a cosine function value of 0. Recall in the unit circle, the x-coordinate is the cosine function value. Notice that pi divided by 2, we do have x equals 0. And now to determine the upper limit with respect to u, we need to determine u when x equals 1 half, which gives us u equals inverse cosine of 1 half. We're looking for an angle that has a cosine function value of 1 half, which should remind us of a 30, 60, 90 reference triangle, where the short leg is 1, hypotenuse is 2, the long leg is square root 3, and notice this angle here, which we'll call u, does have a cosine function value of 1 half, which is equal to 60 degrees, or pi divided by 3 radians, which is the upper limit of integration. And just to check on the unit circle, notice that pi divided by 3 radians, x, or the cosine function value, is 1 half. And now because we have limits of integration with respect to u, we simply determine the antiderivative with respect to u and determine big F of pi divided by 3 minus big F of pi divided by 2. Integrating, we have negative 2 times u squared divided by 2 . Simplifying, the antiderivative is just negative u squared. Big F of pi divided by 3 is the the opposite of the square of pi divided by 3 minus big F of pi divided by 2 is the opposite of the square of pi divided by 2. Simplifying, we have negative pi squared divided by 9 plus pi squared divided by 4. Least common denominator is 36. Simplifying, the common denominator is 36, and the numerator is negative 4 pi squared plus 9 pi squared, which is 5 pi squared. This is the exact value of the given definite integral. I hope you found this helpful.